Manflex SRS, auto thrust blue.
Check. Thrust set.
Checked. A simulator is a device that replicates an aircraft and its environment in order to simulate flight, understand the systems, and how external forces affect the aircraft.
V1. Rotate.
We have weight, lift, thrust, and drag. So weight is the force of gravity. Lift is created by the differential pressure beneath and above the wing. Thrust is the force that propels the aircraft through the sky in the direction of motion, and our engines produce the thrust, and drag is the force that acts opposite the direction of motion. Basically, what we're simulating hydraulically but with electric power is 3,000 pounds per square inch of hydraulic pressure. And airplanes operate with hydraulics as well, but the simulator is fully electric motion based. Virgin America flies the A320 series aircraft, and this is an A320 series simulator. So once you step inside the simulator, it's virtually indistinguishable from the actual aircraft.
So right now it's day. I can select dusk, which is my favorite. We can also select nighttime. You can select dawn as well, which is very similar to dusk. The sun is on the other side, that's all.
How about a steep angle of climb? Ready for that? Okay, here we go. Everybody in their seats? There's a steep angle of climb. Here comes a hard right turn. Here comes a hard left turn. And we'll go back down to 3,000 in level flight. The simulator is being used about 20 hours per day most days of the year.
Full altitude 3,000.
We have standard metrics by which all pilots must adhere, but it's repetition. So if they don't get it right the first time, they do it again and again and again until they get it correct. They come in every 6 months and they're tested and evaluated on all the abnormal procedures, the emergency procedures, and the normal procedures, and they must pass to then be released to go fly for another 6 months. So Nick's gonna go ahead and insert a thunderstorm into the IOS here, the instructor operating station.
So first I just freeze our position so we don't move too far down away from the airport. And now I can select a thunderstorm.
We can add some turbulence as well.
So that's moderate turbulence right now. That's severe turbulence right now.
Add to that wind and rain and hail, and it can get pretty interesting very quickly. By its very nature, simulator training is much, much safer than training in an actual aircraft. So abnormals and emergency procedures can be learned and practiced in a static, safe environment without risk to the crews or the actual airplane. So we can practice hundreds of abnormals and emergency procedures, such as engine fires, engine failures, cabin fires, landing gear problems. Additionally, there are financial benefits to the company because we're not out flying an airplane burning the fuel, and it reduces the environmental impact as well.
200 minimum.
Planning.
Check.
100. 50. 30. Retard. 10.
Spoilers. Reverse green, decel.
So that's the visual approach.
Yeah, so we got no motion on and it feels like we have some, doesn't it?
Yep.
It's quite deceiving. It's your inner ear and your visuals. Yeah. I suppose not so much your inner ear, but your visuals make you feel like.